Hello everyone, myself Bhumi Patel, assistant professor at LGA Institute of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication. Today we will study about the time domain specification use of the second order system. So first of all, response for second order system. Here, in the most of the control system are designed with the damping ratio less than unity. So the time response of the system will always be oscillatory. Now, in the performance characteristic of any control system as specified in the terms of the time response to a unit step input, because if the response to a step input is known, it is mathematically possible to compute the response of any of the input signal. So here a second order system with unit step input and all initial condition are zero, this type of response is given in this diagram. So the transient response of the system to a unit step input depend on the initial condition. For convenience, the transient response of the various systems, it is common practice to use a standard initial conditions that the system is at rest initially with the output and all time derivative is of the zero. So we can easily compile this response. So here you can see that a transient response and after transient response a steady state response is given. Now here all of you know that in the transient response we can get the maximum error. So for that we have derived a different parameter for the second order system response. So here you can see that TD is given, and what is TD? It is the delay time of the system. Next TR is given. TR is known as the rise time of the system. TP is given, it is the peak time of the system. TS is given, it is the settling time of the system. And MP is given, it is the peak overshoot of the system. Now, how we can derive the second order system response? So, for the reason, first reason is how fast the system moves the following the input. The second reason is how oscillatory it is. It is also important. And the third is how long does it take to practically reach the final value. For these three parameters, we can derive the second order system response. So first time is So first parameter is the delay time. Now what is the delay time? The delay time is the time required for the response to reach 50% of the final value in the first time. Here you can see in this response, then whenever the delay time is arise whenever the system reach it's in the 50% of the final value in the first time. So delay time is defined as TD, and the equation of delay time is equal to TD is equal to 1 plus 0.7 zeta upon omega n. Now how it's come, it is derived in the next lecture. So here delay time TD is equal to 1 plus 0.7 zeta upon omega n. Now next one is the rise time. What is the rise time? It is the time required for the response to rise from 10% to 90% of its final value for the overdamped system and 0 to 100% for the underdamped system. Now, how we define it is a overdamped and it is underdamped? It is depend the value of zeta. we can study in the second order system derivation. So rise time, equation for rise time TR is equal to pi minus phi upon omega n under root of 1 minus theta square, when phi is equal to tan inverse of under root of 1 minus theta square upon theta. So this is the equation for rise time. Now what is the maximum overshoot? So the maximum overshoot is the maximum peak value, MP is the maximum peak value of the response curve measured from unity. So here you can see that in this diagram, where is MP? Whenever we can get the maximum peak value, okay, with the reference of unity number. So this point is known as the peak overshoot, maximum overshoot of the system. Now equation of the maximum percentage overshoot MP is equal to CTP minus C infinite upon C infinite. What is the TP? Peak time. So output of peak time minus output of infinite upon infinite. So it is the steady state output. So MP is defined as the percentage MP is equal to e raised to minus pi zeta upon under root of minus 1 minus zeta square into 100%. In most of the control system, the steady output of the step input is the same as the input. For example, if the second order system C infinite is equal to CSS, steady state value is equal to 1, is the same as the input. So the amount of the maximum peak overshoot directly indicate the relative stability of the system, and it is always denoted by MP. Now next is the settling time. What is the settling time? Here you can see that this is the error of the system, and after some time the system becomes stable. So after this time the system goes to the steady state response. So the settling time is defined as the time required for the transient response to reach and stay within a percentage error. So it is the settling time of the system. Now time consumed in increase up to 98% of the final input. So the settling time for a second order system is approximately 4 times the time constant T. So this is the equation for settling time. TS is equal to 4T and is equal to 4 upon zeta omega n. Now the next is the steady state error. It is the difference between the actual output and the desired output at time T. How the steady state error is defined? This is our actual output and this is our desired output. Whatever difference is given, it is known as the steady state error. The equation of steady state error ESS is equal to limit T tends to infinite R of T minus C of T, and is equal to limit S tends to 0 E of S. Okay, S E of S. So this is the parameter of the second order system response. Now example number 1. Here the open loop transfer function of a servo system with the unity feedback is given by the g of s is equal to 10 upon s plus 2 s plus 5. Now what we have to find out, determine that acting ratio, that means zeta, under damped natural frequency of oscillation, what is the percentage overshoot of the response to the unit step input. So here given data, what is given here, g of s is equal to 10 upon s plus 2 s plus 5. And next, h of s is equal to unit feedback, that means h of s is equal to 1. Now we have to find the damping ratio omega n and the peak overshoot. So for that we have to write the characteristic equation. And what is the characteristic equation? 1 plus g of s h of s is equal to 0. So 1 plus g of s is equal to 10 upon s plus 2 s plus 5, and h of s is equal to 1 is equal to 0. So we can get 1 plus 10 upon s square plus 7s plus 10 is equal to 0. So s square plus 7s plus 10 plus 10 means 20 is equal to 0. So this is the equation for the servo system. Now compare s square plus 7s plus 20 is equal to 0 with the standard second order equation, and it is s square 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square is equal to 0. So this is the equation number 1 and equation number 2. Compare 1 and 2, we can get here omega n square is equal to 20. So 20. So we can get omega n is equal to under root of 20 is equal to 4.472, and unit of omega n is equal to radian per second. Now the next term comparison is 2 zeta omega n s is equal to 7s. Cancel the term s. So 2 into zeta omega n is equal to 4.472 is equal to 7. So simplify this equation, we can get zeta is equal to 0.7826. Now the third is, we can find the percentage overshoot, that means percentage of MP. And the equation of percentage of MP is equal to e raised to minus pi zeta upon under root of 1 minus zeta square. So put the value of zeta, e raised to minus pi, into 0.7826 upon under root of 1 minus 0.7826 square, and simplify this equation, we can get 1.9892%. So this is the maximum peak overshoot of this system. So we can get omega n is equal to 4.472 radian per second, zeta is equal to 0.7826, and MP is equal to 1.92%. So this is the example number 1. We can find the damping ratio, undamped natural frequency of oscillation, that means omega n, and peak overshoot. How we can find this type of example? First of all, we can find the characteristic equation, and always we can get the second order characteristic equation. Whatever equation will be given, we can compare with the standard. under second order equation, and for comparing these two equations, we can get the value of omega n and zeta, and using this value, we can find the value of n. Thank you everyone. If anyone have doubt,